Hey guys, hope you are all doing good. In the live classes, we have seen the solution methodology for solving a partial differential equation, and we have taken a linear convection equation as an example, and we have seen the solution methodology. In this video, we'll be learning how to write a computer program to implement the time marching procedure. Okay, so the problem here is del u del t plus a times del u del x is equal to 0, where the value of a is 300 meters per second. And the initial conditions from the problem are given, that is at time t is equal to 0. U of x is equal to 0 from when x ranges from 0 to 50, and u of x is given as a function of sine when the value of x is between 50 and 110, and for the rest, that is from 110 to 300, the value of u of x is 0. And the boundary conditions are also given, that is u of x is equal to 0 when x is 0, and also u of x is 0 when x is equal to L. Okay. Just to refresh your memory, del u del t plus a times del u del x is equal to 0. When we have discretized this equation by using a backward difference scheme, we ended up with this equation, right? So now we'll be moving on to MATLAB for solving the problem. As always, we'll be starting with clear all, close all, and CLC. Then what I'm going to do is take x as an array in space of, as we are having x running from 0 to 300, so I'll be taking 0 comma 300 comma, say I take 61 terms, okay, and let me initialize my dx as x of 2 minus x of 1, because dx is a spacing between two mesh points, and let me take dt as some value 0.02. and then what I can do here is I can initialize my velocity profile here, that is u is equal to zeros of 1 comma 61. So for easiness, what I can do here is I can just write here nx and here nx, and I can take nx as a variable in the starting itself. Then what these zeros of 1 comma nx does is, let me take an example, u equal to zeros of 1 comma nx. So it's telling nx as an undefined variable. So let me take u equal to zeros of 1 comma 10. Then I'm going to get 10 elements, that is one row and 10 columns I'm going to get. And all the elements are zeros, right? And similarly, if we take another example, u equal to ones of 1 comma 10, then I'm going to get all the ones in one row and 10 columns, okay? And then if I do 34 star u, then 34 is going to multiplied in each and every element of x array, okay? So this is how this command works. So after this, what I am going to do is specify my boundary conditions. And what are my boundary conditions? That is u of 1 is always 0 as given in the problem, and u of n, that is the last element, is equal to 0 always, okay, according to this problem. And then what I am going to do here is, if you can observe this problem, what are these initial conditions? That are from x equal to 0 to 50, we have the values of u as zeros, and then from 50 to 110, say this is 50 and say this is 110, okay, and this one is 300, okay, and from 50 to 110 I have a sine wave here, okay. So clearly what I am doing here is I am initializing every point in u array as 0, and then what I can do here is cleverly I can take points from 50 to 110 and then implement this function there, okay. So how am I going to do that? So for that, what I'm going to take is I'm taking u of, if I have 61 terms, then let me execute this thing and see where 50 is occurring. So clearly I can see that 50 is occurring in the 11th column, so I can, and 110 is appearing in the 23rd column. So safely what I can write here is u of 51 east, sorry, not 51, that is 11 east 23, right, is equal to what I can write here is 100 times as given in the function sine of pi star x of 11 is to 23, right, minus 50, that is divided by 60. Okay, so let me run the program and let me also plot this. So it's a good practice to write small programs and proceed further. Okay, and for making it pretty neat, what I'm going to do here is take a grid and also take x label, that is x axis or distance measured along x axis. Okay, and then I'm going to take my y label as you might have guessed, that is velocity, right? If I run the program, so you can see that my initial conditions are ready. That is, from 50 to 110, I got a sine wave as expected, and from 0 to 50 and 110 to 300, I'm getting the values as zeros, right? Now I am done with the initial conditions. What I'm going to do here is make a copy of velocities upref, that is for my previous time step. Okay, so in while writing the program, what we do is for the current time step we take the velocity as u, and for the previous time step we take the velocity as upref. Okay, and I'm going to take upref is equal to u, and then what I'm going to take here is I'm going to take my u initial is equal to u, so that I can compare with my initial velocity profile. Okay, you will appreciate this at the end of the video. Okay, now I'm all set for writing my for loop, that is for I is equal to 2 to nx minus 1. If you attended my live class, then you shouldn't have any problem when on why am I writing from 2 to nx minus 1 and not from 1 to n. Okay, so I'm going to write u of I is equal to u pref of I minus a star dt by dx. Okay, and that is multiplied by u pref of I, sorry, as I'm doing by backward differencing scheme, I'll write u pref of I minus u pref of I minus 1. Sorry, this is I minus 1. Okay, so looks like I haven't given the value of a, so I can write it here. A is equal to 300 as given in the problem. Okay, what can I do here is I can plot my x and u, and also plot my x and u initial. I can also add hold on command. Instead of taking dt as 0.02, let me take it very small, that is 0.002. okay, so now if I execute the program, you can see that this is my initial profile and this is my profile after 0.002 seconds. Okay, you can see here that if my dt is 0.002 seconds, that is the velocity profile that I am going to get here is after 0.002 seconds. Okay, and if I want, and this is for the first time step. Okay, and for the second time step, what I'm going to take here is use the values of u from the first time step, right? So what I'm going to do here is update my values, that is u pref is equal to u. So this you can write here as the comment as update. Okay, then what I'm going to do here is copy this line of code and paste it here, and then I can change this, that this is the second time step. Okay, if I run the program again, then what you can observe here is the velocity profile has moved here, and you can also see that there is a drop in the peak value, right? So if I make it in a full screen, then you can see that my peak has also dropped. Why this peak is dropping, we'll be addressing in the later part of the video. So now what can I do here is, instead of copy pasting this code again and again, what can I do is, I can safely use a nested for loop, right? Instead of first time step, I can take this as a space loop. And above this space loop, I can write a time loop that is for j is equal to 1 to for 100 time steps. Okay, you can observe that after 50 time steps the peak is reducing drastically. This is occurring because we are neglecting the terms of the order delta x square into del square u by del x square. That del square u by del x square term is what is acting as a diffusion term. Okay, that is that meaning this diffusion is causing due to the error that is propagating while we are solving the equation. Okay, now what can I do here is, I can use a central difference scheme for my spatial derivative, that is del u by del x. So for central difference scheme, I have u of I plus 1, that is u prime of I plus 1 minus u prime of I minus 1 divided by 2 delta x. So if that delta x comes to the numerator, I'll be getting 0.5, right? So this is the second order approximation of first order derivative, right? So we'll be expecting more accurate results, right? So if I run the program, then let us see what happens. As we are solving a convection problem, we are expecting the wave to move towards the right. But if you observe here that our minimum velocity is less than the initial condition, that is not what we are expecting, and the maximum velocity is higher than the initial conditions, and that means our solution is not bounded. So this is what we call a solution blow up. So this is occurring because we are using a second order approximation, but our scheme is not stable for this particular problem. So using the right scheme is very important when you are solving CFD problems. Okay, so that's all for this video. Hope you guys liked it. If you did, like it, share it, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, hit the subscribe button along with the notification bell. If you are interested in our course MATLAB for Mechanical Engineers, you can take up, that is available at an affordable price. See you guys in the next video. Bye.